Well, hello there. We're back again after being covered in a gray blanket and all that good stuff up here in northeastern Ohio. But anyway, today is August 28th, 2019. I'm not sure what day of the week it is. Maybe Wednesday, we'll say. Take a guess. And it's 9:07 p.m. up here. Anyway, I've been out here probably about, maybe an hour taking pictures on the other camera, on the Canon 80D. So knowing me, I'll probably put those pictures in here in the video. I'm outside right now taking video, so you never know what's going to happen. Once I go in, check the footage and process everything and all that good stuff. Oh, by the way, I finally caved in and got Lightroom to process the still photos, and I was having so much trouble with on one photo. It was always freezing my Mac constantly, and I really like that program, but so I broke down and I did get Lightroom, and I just hate paying a monthly fee for software. Ugh. It just rankles me. But anyway. So like I said, I probably am throwing in some pictures in here. Oh, and by the way, before we even go up to Jupiter and Saturn, there are a couple of comets heading towards the sun. I think it's called 322P. They're approaching the sun now, and I think by Friday they're going to be doing a slingshot around the moon. And by the looks of the SkySafari Pro app, I saw three tails, so I'm guessing that they're broken up and heading towards the sun. I think it said those comets take a four-year trip around. But anyway, it looked really cool on the SkySafari Pro app, so I wanted to include that in here too. So anyway, after the still photos from the Canon, we're now over onto the Nikon P1000 camera and recording onto the Atomos Ninja Flame. And there we go with the big guy up there. If I recall correctly, Callisto is out there to the far right, and Io is the one closest to Jupiter tonight. That is a cool shot. It's coming in quite well. Okay, there we go. So we have our clips done for stacking to try to help bring out the details of both the moons around Jupiter and Jupiter itself, and if I'm not mistaken, I think we have the Great Red Spot tonight in the lower left-hand corner. It's getting harder and harder to get a good capture of Jupiter right now. And if I said Saturn before, excuse me, but that's a cool look, and Jupiter's over in the southwest, and Saturn, who we're going to next, is over in the southern sky. So that's good enough there for the big guy. And we're going to have the Skywatcher mount take us over to Saturn. Or get us there in the general direction. There it is. Up the top. So that very faint light that's on the screen. Well, I'll probably overlay a picture on here so we know what we're looking at, but okay, so there we go. We got her in Saturn and its cool rings. I have to admit, these two planets are my favorites. Probably because you can actually see some details of, say, the bands and the Great Red Spot on Jupiter and these rings around Saturn. So with the equipment I have, you can't really see much of anything of Venus and Mars except a blob. An orange blob for Mars, and Venus we can get in phases like the crescent moon. But not right now because they're still in the daytime sky. Now I'm not sure how the pictures are going to come out after processing and Lightroom and all that, but I'm going to try to do a good job. And if I happen to overlay a picture of my landscape, of the night sky here, and have these two big planets sitting on top of it, it's not true to life. It's just a bit of creativity. But anyway, the batteries are running down here on my Ninja Flame because I forgot to change them, and we're going to have to call it an early night. So whatever day of the week it is, I'm going to wish you a great one and a wonderful new one ahead. So y'all take care, and the three of us are going to wave goodbye from northeastern Ohio. It's now 9:24 p.m. Good night, everybody.